Hey, this is Izzy with Genelec, and today I'm going to be showing you how to use the MIDI functions within GLM. To get started, you'll see up here in GLM 5, in the top settings menu bar is where you access your MIDI settings. You want to be sure that you've enabled GLM as a MIDI interface and that you've chosen the correct input and output devices. Here we're using a Mac Studio, so I've got the built-in IAC driver buses as my input and output device. As you can see here, this is where you have access to all those CC commands, and you can adjust these as you'd like. Today we're using an Elgato Stream Deck to get this set up. So I'm going to go ahead and open up the Stream Deck application. You can see here I got a blank profile. And the first thing you want to do is make sure you have a MIDI plugin for your Stream Deck. So you can access the marketplace here. What we did was just download this free one. Conveniently, Genelec has created an icon pack for the Stream Deck. If you want to search in the marketplace here for GLM, you'll see our new icon pack. So you want to install that as well. And then we're going to go back to our Stream Deck application here. And for starters, you want to be able to open GLM from Stream Deck. We're just doing open here, and we're going to grab GLM from our applications folder. See that automatically loads in our GLM 5 icon. And then let's get started with some of these MIDI commands. The one we care about really is control change here. We want to click and drag that right onto your Stream Deck. And we'll start with a pretty basic command, your mute, if you want to mute your system. I'm going to go back here into my MIDI settings in GLM and check what CC number that was, and we have it as 48. So I'm going to choose command 48 down here, and I'm going to call it my mute. I'm going to check my MIDI ports here and they're set correctly, but that's where you want to check that. And I'm going to add an icon coming from the icon pack here. Actually, because I got that icon, I don't need to title this. Now, if I press this button, you can see in GLM it's muting my system. So that's great. Next, let's add some volume commands. I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing, click and drag my control change here. Let's do volume up. And if you see here, my volume up is 21. If I go back over here and I choose number 21, I'm gonna use this big plus. I mean, we also have a volume up, volume down here. And then there you go, I've got volume up. And we'll do volume down as well. Same deal, I'm checking what CC command it is, it's 22. Go back over here and I'm gonna choose 22. And I'm gonna add an icon here. There you go, now I can control volume with GLM. Here's another great feature. You can add a command for turning on and off your system. So you can see it's called system power here. And we have that as CC28. So I'm gonna go ahead and same thing I've been doing, set this to 28. And I'm gonna choose this power button here. And now I can turn on and off my speakers right from the Stream Deck. Another thing to note is you can see here in my MIDI settings, we do have some value commands. This is for individual solo and individual mute of a device. And to know what value to set that to, it's actually gonna be on your main screen in GLM. So let's say with my stereo pair of 8331s here, I want to at times solo my right speaker. I'm gonna go into the info mode and I'm gonna click on that speaker. And what's important here is the MIDI ID. So that's tied to its placement on this GLM hive. And so this speaker is ID 3. So I'm gonna go into here I'm gonna drag my control change command, and I already forgot which one it is. So individual solo is 50, and then I'm gonna use MIDI ID 3. So I'm gonna scroll down here and choose 50. I'm gonna set the value to 3. And then I'm gonna say that is solo right. So now when I click this button, it'll solo my right speaker. So we can actually use this feature to do a couple more advanced things with our MIDI commands using multi-action. So I'm gonna show you how we could use multi-action to solo the LFE channel if you're working in an immersive system like we are here. So let me switch to my immersive group. And the goal here is we wanna bypass bass management, and then we also wanna solo that subwoofer. And then that way you're just hearing the low frequency effect channel. So my first step is gonna be bass management bypass, and that is CC27. So in Stream Deck, I created that multi-action, and now I'm gonna go back and put my first control change, and that was 27. I'm just gonna title this Bassman. And then the second thing I wanna do is solo that subwoofer. So I'm gonna create another control change. So this is all under one button. And let me check the MIDI ID on that sub. It is MIDI ID 37. So I'll go to 50. And then I'll set this value to 37. And then I'm going to add an icon here for this multi-action button as my solo LFE. So now if I press this button, you can see the subwoofer is soloed there and bass management is bypassed. You could also make a command so that a single button will solo, let's say, all your height speakers. So this one's actually going to be a multi-action switch. So the difference is that the first time you press the button, it does everything on this one side, and then the second time you press it, it does everything on the two side. So for the one side, we want to solo all six of our height channels. So I'm going to go through and do that. I'm going to check these MIDI IDs. It's 18, 17, 16. 10, 11, and 12 in our room. Right, so now that I've made a control change for each one of those speakers, I want the second time I press that button to just mute and unmute the system so I can clear that status. So I'm gonna remind myself, mute was 48. Right, and then I'll make an icon for this. And we're gonna say it's solo height speakers. So now to show you how that works, I press it first time, all six of those speakers get soloed. I press it the second time and everything clears. Now I'm gonna show you a profile that we've done earlier. These are the commands we use the most. You can see we've got mute, dim, bass management, volume up and down, as well as group up and down. So you can browse through our different calibrations. We can jump to a preset level. We also have that solo LFE, which I showed you how to do earlier, and those solo height speakers, as well as muting our center and soloing that right speaker, and the power button up here as well. I hope this has been helpful, and thanks for watching.